Hey everyone, it's me, Josh Masters, and we are experiencing the Word together. And today we are starting our new study on our year-long journey of learning to be still before God, hear His voice, and how to meditate on God's Word. And this month we're going to be focused on our identity in Christ, who I am in Christ. That is going to be what we're going to explore over the next 4 weeks. And it's so vital because so often the reason that we are not fulfilling the purpose God has for our lives is because our identity is found in the wrong thing. It's found in our work or what other people think of us or what the world has told us about us or what our trauma has told us about us. And we're not seeing ourselves through God's eyes. So over the next 4 weeks, we're going to spend time together learning who I am in Christ, discovering my true identity. And you can either get this workbook, which is linked in the comments, and follow along using the workbook, or you can just use a notebook. That's okay too. But we're going to start day one with who I was. Now, most of the study is going to be focused on who I am now in Christ. But we want to start day one by saying who I was, who I used to be before Christ. And we're going to do that by looking at Romans 3, 9 through 23. And today I'm going to read from the NLT. So I want to encourage you, as I read, sort of close your eyes if you can, if you're not driving, obviously, and listen to what the Holy Spirit is speaking to you. Which words and phrases is the Holy Spirit pointing out to you? And that's what you'll meditate on when this video is over. So let me pray for us, and then I will read our passage. Father God, we are so grateful that you give us a new identity, that you fill us with your hope and your purpose and your ministry, and you give our lives meaning in a way that we can't find on our own. And so, Lord, I pray that as we walk through this study together, that you would build us up in community, that you would encourage us individually, and that you would draw us closer to you. As we read your word today, let us have our ears opened by you. Let us have our hearts opened by you, our minds opened by you, so that we can hear what it is you want to say to us. And we ask this in the holy name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Romans chapter 3, starting in verse 9. Well then, should we conclude that we Jews are better than others? No, not at all. For we have already shown that all people, whether Jews or Gentiles, are under the power of sin. As Scripture says, no one is righteous, not even one. No one is truly wise. No one is seeking God. All have turned away. All have become useless. No one does good, not a single one. Their talk is foul, like the stench from an open grave. Their tongues are filled with lies. Snake venom drips from their lips. Their mouths are full of cursing and bitterness. They rush to commit murder. Destruction and misery always follow them. They don't know where to find peace. They have no fear of God at all. Obviously, the law applies to those to whom it was given. For its purpose is to keep people from having excuses and to show that the entire world is guilty before God. For no one can ever be made right with God by doing what the law commands. The law simply shows us how sinful we are. But now, God has shown us a way to be made right with Him, without keeping the requirements of the law, as was promised in the writings of Moses and the prophets long ago. We are made right with God by placing our faith in Jesus Christ. And this is true for everyone who believes, no matter who we are, for everyone has sinned. We all fall short of God's glorious standard. Yet God, with undeserved kindness, declares that we are righteous. That's the beginning of verse 24, a little bit of an extra. So I want to encourage you, please, engage with this community throughout this month. But now get alone, go through that passage again in whatever translation works best for you. Ask the Holy Spirit what he wants to point out to you, and then walk through the five steps of experiencing the Word, which is a modernized version of Lectio Divina. And if you don't know that, you're just joining us and you stumbled across this video, that's wonderful. That's great. It's okay. I will put a link in the video so that you can look at a different video that walks you through the five steps of Lectio Divina through experiencing the Word and how we learn to meditate on the Bible together. So welcome to this study. I'm so glad that you're here. We'll see you tomorrow.